Did the recent wind and hailstorms take you by surprise? This is Southeastern head football coach Frank Selfo. At Pride Roofing, they will visit your home and give you a free roofing inspection. Yes, that's right, a free roofing inspection. Pride Roofing is locally owned and operated and is the official roofer of Southeastern Athletics.
But I can remember being in eighth grade, and I would always feel like everybody talked to me, but nobody told me who I was. And you can spend a lifetime trying to find out who you are. I wanted to speak from, and I'm not going to read the scripture, but I'll tell you where it comes from. 1 Samuel 16:1-23. It's the story of David when he became king. It was a very interesting situation because Samuel, the judge at the time, God told him to go to Jesse's house and to anoint the new king. The problem was when Jesse found out, he brought seven sons, and none of those sons were chosen. Now, what's interesting, Samuel asked him, is there someone else? He had to go fetch for David. So you think about being a child and somebody's coming to the house. Normally you get prepared for the family to meet everybody. Sorry about that. But the thing that was very interesting was David wasn't invited. He was left in the field to do his work. And I think about how many times as we come up as kids, we feel left out. We feel like we're not invited to the party. We feel like we're not good enough. But the thing that was interesting was God chose David. No matter what the father thought of him, you don't even hear the mention of the mother, but all you hear about is Jesse. Jesse didn't think much of David, and he was the youngest of all the kids. And I think about how a lot of times we miss out on our goals in life because we go based off of what other people think. We think that we're not good enough because of what other people think about us. And it's just not true. I mean, what they do and think about us, thank you, what they do or say about us, it affects us emotionally, but it really has no place. Because when God chooses you, you chose it. So you see David, he's anointed king. And when he gets in position of being king, he never tried to prove anything to his father. He never came back to try to prove anything to his brothers. He didn't get in position and try to show them, I'm the chosen one. And a lot of times, even as adults, when we get older, we never forget about how people made us feel. And we try to reach success from a place of hurt. The problem is you can never properly heal because hurt is your motivator. And even as kids, we get hurt. So the most healthy thing to do is learn that I need to know what God thinks about me. That way, when I get to the place of my appointed time, I can be prepared. David was prepared through isolation. He was a shepherd, so he raised sheep. This is the thing that was interesting. Jesse could not teach David how to be a king. And Jesse was his father. Jesse was never a king. And if you know the story of the Israelites, it was 12 tribes. The Israelites chose kings from the tribe of Benjamin. Well, David was from the tribe of Judah. And a lot of times in our life, God will break the tradition. He'll choose you and he'll give you something nobody can help you with, but he'll help you. And ultimately, he wants the relationship with him. I think about being in the eighth grade now in 2023, and if you see what our kids need now more than anything is motivation. We have enough rappers. We have enough athletes. We don't have enough scholars. And we have to find out a way to, thank you. We have to find out a way to make education more appealing, because we're losing our kids. And this is the thing. I say to the eighth grade class, as you transition to high school will be your first environment of competition. America is a land of opportunity, and you have to seize that opportunity. It is a global world, and we're competing with people that are all across the world. I think about this. I come from Southern University. That's where I got my undergrad from, in accounting. And I graduated in 2020, and the world had shifted. It used to be, in order to get a minority, you go to an HBCU. Well, you can get a minority at Harvard now. So you don't just, the competition level, I have to be able to compete with everybody. And competition is healthy. I always say, when you have to earn something, you appreciate it. When you give in something, you don't value it. And we give our kids too much. We give them too much. Sometimes the best thing for them is a little struggle. Because what happens when you're not here to save them? We never think about preparing them for life. We just throw them in them. We kind of fall into life haphazardly, but that's how we fell into it. And we're not intentional about how we do things. So if we're going to reach this new generation, we have to be intentional. We have to say what we mean and mean what we say, because they mean it when they say it. When they say something, they mean it. If they tell you they're not going to do it, normally, they're not going to do it. So I would say encourage that we have to understand the value of free education. I always say, coming from Southern University, I deserve a seat at the table too. And if you don't give me a seat, I'll go make my own table. That was always my mindset. I come from a family where excuses were not allowed. My grandmother and my mother would always say, if you can't do it, figure it out. Those life skills of trying to learn how to figure it out, that's how you survive. It is very important that we teach our kids some things in life you have to figure out. Everybody has a story. If everybody had a mic, somebody in here, everybody, especially adult, has a situation in their life where it felt like it wasn't fair. Everybody has taken losses. Everybody has gotten the short end of the stick. But the thing that separates us is somebody chose to keep going. They didn't make an excuse about why it didn't happen. You have to recalibrate in life, and you have to figure it out. But I want to end with this. One of the things that's very important to survival in life is perspective. How do you view things? I always say the worst power to have is the power you never knew you had. That's the worst power to have. What you don't want, and I say this to eighth graders, to get in your 20s, 30s, 40s, and 50s, talking about what people didn't do for you, what you wasn't willing to do for yourself. We have to become accountable to the decisions that we make and understand where we at in life. We made some of those decisions. There were times where our parents told us not to do it. We did it anyway. The mama said, don't marry him. We married him anyway. Daddy said, that ain't the one. We had to have it. So it was one of those things consequences taught us. But consequences are healthy. They're not bad things. Ms. Hammer uses a word, and I heard her this morning when she was on intercom, expectation. I'm a firm believer that in this life, when God forgives you, he throws it into the sea of forgiveness. But when man forgives you, he never forgets. He never forgets. So we have to understand how we treat people matter as well. Because that person that you're nasty to today may be the person that has to give you a job 20 years down the road. People will always remember how you made them feel. Thank you.
I'm Michael.
I'm Alex.
At Pride Roofing, we handle commercial and residential work.
TPO, shingle and metal inventory,
we got it.
Property still in disarray from the recent hurricanes and hailstorms. Insurance claims?
No problem.
Call 855-PRIDE16. Se habla Español.